The Vulture Mine is silent now, except for the murmur of tourists and the scurrying of desert animals. But it wasn't always so. From the discovery of gold by Henry Wickenburg in 1863 until its close in 1942, the Vulture Mine and Vulture City hummed with the sound of stamp mills, generators, horses, wagons, trucks, and the happy babble of children at their school desks. The Vulture's boom and bust story could have come straight from a Hollywood screenwriter. Vulture City was the place to be for everyone from wild-eyed speculators to pioneer families. Thousands of people relied on the mine for the fulfillment of their dreams or just the promise of a good living. Many were disappointed, but others prospered, and so did the state of Arizona. The Vulture Mine's discovery led to the founding of Wickenburg. Some who were attracted by the area's potential for riches went on to discoveries which spurred the growth of Phoenix, such as Jack Swilling, who helped restore the ancient Native American canals in the Salt River Valley. Statehood was accelerated by the prosperity the Vulture brought to central Arizona. Without the Vulture Mine, it's safe to say that the state and the Southwest would not have blossomed. Since the mine was closed in 1942, the site has been preserved by a series of dedicated caretakers. But today, this important site is in peril. Weather and decades of neglect are taking their toll. Buildings are crumbling. Artifacts are being lost as walls crumble or are being looted. One of the most historically important structures on the property, the 1884 Essay Building, where the gold was stored before shipment, is now closed to visitors. The once sturdy walls are slowly disintegrating. The wooden floors are warped. The roof is threatening to fall in or fall off. This sad story plays out all over the property. The 1880s headframe, once the proud tall sentinel of the Vulture, is now a pile of rotting wood. The superintendent's house from the same period is no longer the domestic oasis it once was. And the mess hall has completely fallen apart. Today, tourists can visit the mine, but they go home wondering why the place is in such bad shape. And they never learn the Vulture's contributions to the history of the state and the region. In late 2009, it seemed the Vulture was doomed. But a group of committed citizens got together from the Vulture Mine Preservation and Restoration Association. A registered nonprofit, our association began raising awareness of the Vulture's condition through a website. We have pulled together ambitious but realistic goals. We plan to begin restoration by stabilizing three buildings that are on public land, the 1881 and 1934 schoolhouses, and the early 20th century gatehouse. We also have an architect creating a rehabilitation plan to identify the buildings that can be saved on private land. But our goals are bigger than just restoring buildings. The real value of the Vulture Mine site is to help visitors to gain an understanding of Arizona's history.
What we want to do from a broader perspective is make this an interpretive site. So not just, oh yeah, that's a nice school building, but what did it mean? What did it mean to be able to sit in a building like this? Did they have boys and girls together? How many teachers did you have? What did you have for books? What was it like to be out here with the boom, boom, boom of the crushers and the stamp mill? And just, you know, so people can really absorb that kind of feeling and find out what really started the state of Arizona, because Arizona started because it was a mining area. That's what brought people here.
We can make the Vulture a living symbol of Arizona history to pass on to future generations. But given the current condition of the buildings that can be saved, we are in a race with time.
It has to be now, because you can see from some of the buildings, they're not going to be here too much longer if someone doesn't step up and do something to save them. And we're not talking about making this a Disneyland, but just restoring it to the point where it's safe for families to come into the schoolhouse and sit down and get a feel of the place.
But we cannot preserve this important part of Arizona's history without your help. We need cheerleaders, donors, and volunteers. We need you. Go to the website, become a member, make a contribution, and become part of our effort to save the Vulture Mine for future generations.